Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD, bodybuilder, here with my fifth video in the series, Basics of Training. In this video, we'll be talking all about training intensity and rep ranges. So, as a brief introduction, the definition of intensity is basically the amount of weight that you're lifting. So say that your one repetition maximum in the squat is 300 pounds. If you were squatting 150 pounds now, that's 50% of your one rep maximum. And that is an intensity. Now, from the literature that we have so far, basically, as long as you're lifting with greater than 30% of your one rep maximum and taking sets to failure, you will get about the same amount of growth. Practically speaking, that means that any set that's 30 reps or less taken to failure will result in similar hypertrophy. This is why we usually count our volume in terms of the number of hard sets, rather than actually calculating number of sets times number of reps times the amount of weight lifted, which is the technical definition of volume. Now, what's a hard set? Basically, a hard set is a set taken to a sufficient relative intensity. Relative intensity is the proximity you take a set to failure. Going all the way to failure is a very high relative intensity, and stopping a set when you have 4 reps left in the tank is a lower relative intensity. For our intents and purposes, we usually count a hard set as one that's taken to 4 reps in reserve or fewer. You'll see a lot of people who are in favor of taking all of their sets to failure. Now, I'll say that training to failure is not necessarily a bad thing, but it's something that should be used cautiously depending on how much volume you want to perform. The thing is, training to failure is very fatiguing, and it limits the amount of volume that you can do in a week. Now, if you're only in the gym twice per week, it makes sense to go to failure and really push yourself because you're going to have a few days to recover before the next session. On the other hand, if you're training 4 days a week or more, I would suggest using failure very sparingly. Now, my general recommendation for beginners is to train with 1 to 2 reps in reserve. Why not just train with 4 reps in reserve, because it'll produce less fatigue and still gives us that hard set. My main reason is that when you get beyond 2 or 3 reps in reserve, it gets hard to judge how close you are to failure in actual fact. There is literature to say that people are very bad at judging how close they are to failure. And if you think you have 4 reps left in the tank, but actually have 6 or 7, you won't be getting as much growth as you could be. So I just said that sets of less than 30 reps, as long as they're taken to sufficient relative intensity, will produce similar growth. So why not do all our work in sets of 3 or sets of 30? The reason is there are a few other concepts that come into play that narrow down our ideal rep ranges. In general, I like Dr. Eric Helm's recommendation of 2/3 to 3/4 of your volume to be done in the 6 to 12 rep range, and the rest to be done outside of that rep range. The 6 to 12 rep range is actually what is commonly recommended in traditional bodybuilding, and it's actually ideal for the most part for a few reasons. The thing is, when you go below 6 reps and use heavy weight, you generate a lot of fatigue per set. The problem with fatigue is it limits the amount of work that we can do over an entire week. Furthermore, low rep sets with heavy weight also generates a lot of connective tissue damage, which can lead to chronic injuries. So, although doing, say, heavy sets of squats in the 3 to 5 rep range might be great for building strength, it actually generates a lot of fatigue in one session, and you will probably be able to do more volume if you did sets of, say, 8. As you recall, in our staircase of training priorities, volume actually ranks higher than intensity and rep ranges. Our rep ranges should be set in a way that allows us to maximize the amount of volume that we can do over a week. The reason why we don't usually do sets greater than 20 reps is because they're just very mentally fatiguing. If you've ever tried it, doing a set of squats for 30 reps all the way to 2 reps shy of failure is actually immensely painful. Okay, now that we've talked about the intensities and the rep ranges that we should be shooting for, how do we set this up in real life? Let's use quads as an example. In this example, we'll be training the quads twice per week, according to our frequency recommendation. And this will be in the context of, say, a full body split or perhaps an upper lower split. And according to our volume recommendation of 10 to 20 sets per body part per week, let's say we'll be training quads for 10 sets per week. Now, using our recommendation of about 2/3 of your volume in the 6 to 12 rep range, let's say that we'll be doing 7 sets in the 6 to 12 rep range and 3 sets outside of that rep range. Now, what does that look like? On day 1, 1 heavy set of 5, and then we do 4 sets of leg press in the 8 to 12 rep range. On day 2, we're going to squat 3 sets, 6 to 10 reps, and then we're going to do leg extensions for 2 sets in the 12 to 15 rep range. And how does this work into our recommendation? We said we were doing 7 sets in the 6 to 12 rep range. So we've got 4 sets here in the leg press, 8 to 12 reps, and 3 sets here in the squat, 6 to 10 reps. That leaves us with 3 sets outside of the 6 to 12 rep range. And here we used 1 set of squats for 5 reps and 2 sets of leg extensions at 12 to 15 reps. Now lastly, I'll mention that different exercises work best in different rep ranges. Compound movements usually work better in the lower rep ranges. The reason is that higher rep ranges generate a lot of systemic fatigue. Now, what are compound movements? These are usually movements that use more than one joint and are usually bilateral. Examples would be the squat, deadlift, bench press, overhead press, and barbell row. Now, isolation movements, those involving just one joint, usually work better in higher rep ranges. That's just because usually for an isolation movement, it's difficult to actually move heavy weights with good balance and coordination. If you do try and use low reps and heavy weights, you tend to risk cheating a lot, which shifts the emphasis onto other muscle groups, and you also risk injury. So now that we have an idea of what intensity to use and what rep ranges to use, and we know that these work differently for different exercises, which exercises do we choose then? That is the topic of our next video. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and leave me a comment. Let me know what you want to see next on Ask Dr. Swole. See you next time.